started asking a question to people, and when you ask this question, be ready for some answers. And I just basically said, tell me what you really think of me. Now, and I said, I won't get mad, I won't do anything. And I started with the psychiatrist who knew me for many years and who, you know, who knew my behaviors. And then I went on to my family and very close friends, and they all said the same thing. They said, well, you're pretty much close to being a psychopath. We've been telling you for years. I said, no, you said I was crazy. I said, you're not crazy. He said, but all these things, and they went through these specific behaviors. And when I saw them all there, it kind of hit me. Then I got, you know, analyzed, psychoanalyzed, and all this stuff, and took the test. And I'm a borderline. I'm not a full categorical psychopath. I'm what you call a pro-social psychopath. Sounds nice. It's also called a successful psychopath, which basically means you haven't been caught. So one reason you don't know me is because I've been hiding all these years, and you didn't quite know that. So anyway, to get back to this, I still didn't understand why I wasn't really much worse than I was, even though I have behaviors that are not so charming, and I have all these pro-social symptoms and traits. And I looked at it, and it didn't make sense to me. And then when I was looking at it just a couple of years ago, I looked at some of the alleles, and one of them was a serotonin transporter. And I have these so-called warrior genes. I'm just loaded with them. But some of these, they're only warrior genes if you're abused or abandoned early in life, especially from, you know, from birth to the first few years. But it was found out in a monkey, another paper in humans, that if you're treated really in a nurturing environment, it erases some of the other negative characteristics. So this was really the first aha moment.